Hello, 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 and welcome to Learning English TV with Steve Ford. This is a new video series to review points that I've talked about in previous videos, Peppy videos, pronunciation videos, TOEFL IELTS videos, parallel videos, and also to answer many questions that I receive from my students worldwide. So, today we are going to talk about I idioms that came from Peppy 19, and I'm going to review those I idioms with you, and I'm also going to explain a few more in the context of some student questions that I have received worldwide. So let's go. Well, my first question comes in from Tone from Vietnam. And Tone's question is, if someone gave you the evil eye, would you feel it? Thank you very much for your question, Tone. Let's try to review what to give someone the evil eye is. You will recall from my video quickly that it is to look with someone with a negative intention. So, would I feel it if someone were giving me the evil eye? You can bet on it.
I would feel the hairs kind of rising on the back of my neck.
As if someone were firing their laser negative eyes upon my neck. So you can see that giving someone the evil eye is like that. Some people will try to protect themselves from the evil eye. They will cross their fingers. They will cross their arms. They might buy some plant to protect themselves for those who do believe in the evil eye. So thank you very much for your question. The next one from Peppy 19 is black eye, or to give someone a black eye. This question comes from Hans from Switzerland. Hans, who also plays hockey, wanted to know that when I was younger and I played hockey, a very good guess, by the way, Hans. I guess you know that 99% of Canadians played hockey when they were younger. If I ever got a black eye, or if someone ever gave me the black eye when I was playing hockey when I was younger. And what I can tell you is that luckily I was one of the bigger players, so nobody messed with me when I was playing hockey, simply because I was so big. The next one was to see eye to eye with someone. You will recall from the video that meant to agree with someone. And my question is actually a statement. It comes from Isabella from Italy, who says that I don't see eye to eye with my supervisor. Are there other people in the same situation as I am in? And thank you very much for your comment, Isabella, about seeing eye to eye, or in this case, not seeing eye to eye with your supervisor. I'm really sorry to hear that. And yes, many of the people that I come across often tell me that sometimes it's difficult to get along with their supervisor and see eye to eye, to get on with your supervisor. So you try to do the best that you can, try to be on the same page to eventually see eye to eye as much as you can with your supervisor. It's a daily chore of give and take, and I'm sure that we can all work at it. The next one you will recall from the video was to keep an eye on someone. To keep an eye on someone simply means that you are watching someone like a hawk. And my question here is if you think that it's common for fathers to keep an eye on their young daughters. And that one comes from Rafael from Brazil, or Rafael from Brazil. Thank you very much for that question, Rafael. And definitely, I know many people who have daughters, and for sure, for certain, I think it's a given that they have to keep an eye on their daughters. So I hope that answers your question. Once again, to keep an eye, to look very closely, to watch someone. The last one is a question which comes from Vladimir from Russia. And Vladimir asks me, when I was a teacher in the classroom, if I had eyes in the back of my head. And I don't think as much eyes, but perhaps ears. Yes, I have very sensitive ears. So even when I was writing on the board, had my back towards the students during a test, I could always hear the last student in the last row in the back of the room if they were trying to whisper something. So you could say that a lot of students, when I detected that something was going on in the class, they thought that I had eyes in the back of my head. I think definitely there are some teachers who have that skill. They're able to perceive things that are going on behind them without actually seeing it with their own two eyes. Okay, so I'm just going to talk about a few more I idioms before we wrap up this video. We have, for example, to only have eyes for someone. There's a great song about that, to only have eyes for someone. And it means that you really, when you love somebody, you only look at that person and nobody else. So that's a very romantic phrase that you can put that into your treasure chest of knowledge there. Next one is eyesore. Eyesore is something which is not visually pleasant. It's something which offends the eye, eyesore. I'll include some links for that where you can see that there are the top 10 buildings which are considered an eyesore. And quite surprisingly, a lot of those eyesore buildings are located in the same capitals that have some wonderful landmarks and buildings as well. Next one, probably one of my favorite ones out of the extra eye idioms, is to have a bird's eye view. To have a bird's eye view means that you are able to see things from a more distant perspective. You stand back and you are able to see things, figuratively speaking, you have a bird's eye view of the situation. There are many ways that you can do that. You can sit down, relax, meditate. You can go for a walk in nature. Many people have different strategies for how you can gain a bird's eye view of a problem so that you can solve it. In a more objective sense, to have a bird's eye view means that you go somewhere up high. You can go to the Rocky Mountains, you can go to the Swiss Alps, you can go to the Himalayas and many other mountain ranges. I'm a little biased, of course, because I live in Vancouver and we have the Rocky Mountains. You can go up the mountains in a gondola, you can go up the mountains in a, what we call a sky ride, and you can have a bird's eye view of the city looking all the way down. There are other adventure sports like that, like hang gliding, parachuting, and quite recently, zip gliding. Those are some great sports that you can do to have a bird's eye view of the land down below. Bird's eye view, great one. My next one is in the wink of an eye. This is another one of my favorites. We know that time is very subjective, and many times we feel that time can go by in the wink of an eye, and you can't hold the flow of time. Nothing can. And it is all very relative. You can be sitting in a waiting room, waiting to do something unpleasant, and a minute can seem like 10 days. You can have a 10-day vacation or holiday, and those 10 days can go by in the wink of an eye. Wink is what I'm doing right now. Your eye closes, it opens very quickly. So you could say in the blink of an eye or in the wink of an eye. My challenge for you is, can you name 5 things in your life that have gone by in the wink of an eye? My next extra idiom is eyes are the window to the soul. A wonderful one as well, very poetic, right up there with I only have eyes for you. Eyes are the window to the soul means simply that you can see exactly who someone is by looking into their eyes. There are many cultures when you are trying to negotiate, it is essential that you look into someone's eyes. So that is a segue into my last expression, look me in the eye and say that, which simply means that if somebody wants to trust you, they have to look in your eyes. So I hope that you enjoyed all of my eye idiom review from Peppy19. I hope you enjoyed the extra eye idioms that I have provided you. And I hope you enjoyed the first episode of Learning English TV with Steve Ford. Have a great morning, a great afternoon, and a great evening. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.